What's going on, everyone? Today we're brewing up a very special beer. It's a beer that I've been looking to brew since I started this channel, and it's a beer that brings back a lot of memories for me. This beer is the Colt 45. Let's go! The beer we're brewing today is kind of lagerish. It's gonna pack a punch, come in at around 8% alcohol, and it has a lot of adjuncts. Let's go over the grain bill. First off, we're gonna start with 4 kilograms of pale malt. Then we're gonna jump right into the adjuncts, which I'm gonna start with 150 grams of Crystal 60. And then we're gonna go into some fancier lager-y adjuncts. We're gonna go with 850 grams of flaked corn and one boot or 500 grams of flaked rice. The pièce de résistance, 800 grams of dextrose to get that alcoholic goodness in there. This one will work. And pretty straightforward, just a few little hops. We're just going in at 1 ounce or 28 grams of Hallertau hops. For the water, I'm just gonna be putting in 0.5 gram of gypsum, 0.5 gram of calcium chloride, and 1 gram of Epsom salts, just to give it a little dose of something. And something I didn't mention, I'm just gonna throw some rice hulls in here just for good measure, and we got a lot of sticky adjuncts. Probably don't need them, but some rice hulls are a cheap way to hopefully not get a stuck mash. And we'll be mashing in at 65 degrees. I'm gonna get a bit of grist where it's not supposed to be. As you can see here, I hooked that upside down, so I gotta reach in and try to make it work. That's a little better. Wasn't as bad as I thought. Recently, my efficiency has been a little off. I adjusted the grain mill. It's a little bit finer of a crush right now. And another thing that I'm gonna be doing that I got from my buddy Carl is I'm just gonna leave it about 5 or 10 minutes after mashing in, just in order to hopefully get a little bit more of them sugars in before I start recirculating it. Not sure if that does anything, but it can't hurt. See if I can get better than the 60% efficiency I got last time. And as you can see here, the wort is super clean so far. Gonna be the best beer ever. And now to show that I brewed it, sparging. Ooh. Hopping. Ooh. And sugaring. Ooh. Okay, so this has been a super long brew day. Had a lot of delays in between. Had to take a kid to a basketball game. But we are down to the wire. We just need to pitch the yeast. For the yeast today, because it was slightly cheaper, I'm using the Mangrove Jack Bow Pills lager yeast. Let's see how that works. I'm using 2 packs. This thing's packing a punch. It's somewhere in the 1.068 specific gravity range, so 3 packs might have even been an idea, but not quite at the point of really calculating yeast yet. That'll be for another video. Okay, that's about it. The brew day's done. Long ass day, but let's see how this is gonna work. Fermenting. Glycol chiller. She's gonna ferment at about 12 degrees, hopefully, and that should make it pretty good. I'm gonna keep it in for about 2 weeks, maybe cold crash it, keep it another 2 weeks. Don't really have time, have about a month to get this thing out for a Christmas beer exchange. The perfect beer for Christmas. Anyway, to the future.
So remember when I said I should've used more yeast? Yeah, I should've used more yeast. The Bohemian strain from Mangrove Jacks recommends 4 packs in a 5-gallon batch when the specific gravity is above 1.050. That gets expensive, so I recommend making a starter with a few packs instead of spending all that money. As you can see from the profile, the 2 packs kinda went stagnant around day 7, so I waited a few days and pitched another pack I had. The fermentation then finished off nicely. Just don't mind that huge spike in temps when I turned off the chiller to try to get the fermentation going again. Phenolics, here we come. But other than that, it started at 1.072 and finished at 1.009, giving us a sweet 8.2% alcohol, which is perfect for canning and packing up for your Christmas beer exchange. They're gonna love it.
Okay, so there's a few hiccups, but we made it to the tasting. Let's give this thing a go. First off, have a look at it. Looks like a decent little head on it. It's not as clear as I would have liked it to be. However, that's not too bad considering I didn't really have too much of a chance to lager it or anything for too long. So yeah, nice brownish color. Let's go in for a whiff. Yeah, for aroma, smells malty, no real crazy hop bitterness or anything in there, which is to be expected. And let's go for the taste, see if this tastes like a Colt 45. Okay, so I guess not surprisingly, I'm getting a little bit of phenolic taste off of there. Kind of spicy, not quite super clovey or anything, but almost like there's a little bit of cinnamon or something like that in there, which probably has to do with the crazy fluctuation in temperatures, but let's go for another little hit. Yeah, so I definitely failed at making a good Colt 45 clone. This is surprisingly decent for an 8% lager. It's kind of easy to drink, probably too easy to drink, and I like it, which wasn't what it was supposed to be. It's a decent beer, too bad I only have a little bit left, although I did have some cans made up, and by cans made up, I mean I just made some cans. Strong beer, works every time, 8.2, guess the only way to get that off is to, drink. Yeah, it's not near the alcohol burn I was gonna expect for the 8%. Probably wasn't the greatest idea for, that, but good enough. And I guess let's see how this one compares. I don't even know why I'm opening it. It's not gonna be anything like it. And I probably should have kept some in the glass to compare it to, but So right off the bat, you can tell this one's a lot lighter than the other one. Definitely clear, brilliant color. Head's, it's a little bit finer head, although it's kind of opening up, probably because I used a messy glass. But you can see there, probably could have lightened up the beer a little bit. It's not as far off as I thought. Definitely a little bit spicier with the clone. I think I like the clone a little bit better, and I'd say clone, but kind of shitty clone, like cloning something if I tried to do it, which I guess is what happened. But yeah, it's not Colt 45, I guess it's surprisingly not as bad as I expected. I wouldn't drink it all the time, but I guess it works every time. Thanks a lot for watching. If you didn't already, might as well hit that subscribe button. If you liked the video, why don't check out some more of these videos in case there's something that interests you, and maybe subscribe. Oh wait, I already mentioned that. Okay, whatever. Buy a hat. Check out the description for links like that, and yeah, thanks a lot.